enemies. Let the rain fall on my enemies. All of my enemies. Yeah, let the rain fall on my enemies. All of my enemies.
Can't keep the deal, then just be honest.
Just be honest.
I can never die, I'm Chuck Norris.
Chuck Norris.
Fuck the government and fuck Boris, yeah.
Now I tell your ghost I wanted to be your girl in a white t-shirt over coffee, stirring in the cinnamon.
Where did you get that?
Where do you think? Duck.
Don't trust one and two. I'll take this side, you hold them off. I'll go find PETA.
Thank you for that. I have one more question for you. It's about your sister. We were all very moved, I think, when you volunteered for her at the reaping. Did she come and say goodbye to you?
Yes. She did.
She did. And what did you say to her in the end?
I told her that I would try to win. That I would try to win for her.
Of course you did. Try you will.
Ladies and gentlemen from District 12, Katniss 17 to go!
This is my assistant, Masala.
It's an honor to meet you.
And your cameraman over there, Castor?
Hello.
And Pollux.
Let's get locked in.
You're all from the Capitol? Plutarch got you out? Don't expect much chit-chat from him. Capitol cut his tongue out years ago. And no, it wasn't any sort of rescue, if that's what you mean. We all fled on our own. For this. For you.
But if not friends and allies,
what do I need to do?
When you and Peter are on tour, you need to smile. You need to be grateful. But above all, you need to be madly prepared to end it all in love. You think you can manage that?
Yes.
Yes, what?
I'll convince them.
No. Convince me. For you, Miss Everdeen. Do convince me. For the sake of your loved ones.
Brutus and Anabaria.
It's with her teeth.
She had them filed into fangs so she could rip people's throats out.
She's committed, I'll give her that.
Wyrus and Beatty. Not fighters, but brilliant. And weird. Real tech savvy. He won his games by electrocuting 6 tributes at once. The Morphlings, masters of camouflage, basically won their games by hiding until everyone else was dead. Self-medicating ever since, which I applaud, not a threat.
Finnick O'Dare, right?
Yes, he won his games at 14, youngest ever, extremely humble.
You're kidding?
Yes, I'm kidding. He's a peacock, a total preener. But he's the capital darling. They love him here. Charming, smart, and very skilled at combat, especially in water.
What about weaknesses?
One, Mags. She volunteered for Annie.
Seven from District. And Rue with a score of 7.
Now find the district.
From District 12. Peter Malark. A score of 8.
Excellent.
Peter!
Yeah, bravo. Yeah.
We can work with that.
And finally, from District 12, Katniss Everdeen. With a score of 11.
Would serve as a reminder of our generosity and our forgiveness. This is how we remember our past. This is how we safeguard our future.
I just love that. Now, the time has come for us to select one courageous young man and woman for the honor of representing District 12 in the 74th annual Hunger Games. As usual, ladies first.
I'm so fucking bored. How long is this gonna take? And also, if anyone's interested, I really don't think this is the right approach at all at this time. I mean, is this really the direction we want to go down? Like, really? Seriously, people. The streets are on fire. And people are gathering, people are trapped, and people, you know, aren't going to care about the shape of my boobs or the length of my hair, surely, right? We should be doing something more proactive. I'm just gonna sit here now, aren't I? And you're just gonna stare at me like that.
Out of sight, I'm out of mind. I do it all for you in time. And out of all these things I've done, I think I love you better now. And I'm gonna paint you bananas and color you in.
The final 2020 presidential debate between President Donald J. Trump and former Vice President Joe Biden. Tonight's debate is sponsored by the Commission on Presidential Debates. It is conducted under health and safety protocols designed by the Commission's health security advisor. The audience here in the hall has promised to remain silent. No cheers, boos, or other interruptions, except right now, as we welcome to the stage former Vice President Joe Biden and President Donald J. Trump. Why don't I hear anything? There must be something wrong with the arrows, right? Right?
It's warmer now, huh?
Much.
I used to sleep with my sister like this.
What's her name?
Pam. Primrose.
Is she the one?
Yeah.
So, do you like that boy?
You talk about anything else.
Well, if you don't like him, how come you asked about him?
I asked because I think he might have saved me. But I don't know if I was just imagining it because of the Jackers.
No, they never make you see good things. Nobody saved you in those dreams.
Of the votes have been counted. Pennsylvania alone would be enough to hand him the keys to the White House. But tonight, President Trump has said he will continue his legal fight and would never give up fighting for the American people. With all but six states left to declare, Joe Biden has 253 electoral college votes and Donald Trump has 214. 270 is the number needed to win the presidency. Counting is still going on in six states, including key ones like Pennsylvania, Nevada, Arizona, and in Georgia, where the margins are so tight, there's going to be a recount.
Time to walk towards the unforgiven. Bitter mercy, forever bitter mercy, masquerading as pain upon pain, breath upon pain. Hope takes a step, static, like a stranger in the wind. All I feel is rain. The clocks stop. My breath stops. Matter becomes mind. And mind becomes matter. Hope screams and then dissolves.